In SwiftUI, using a coordinator for navigation is the best choice when you need fine-grained control over complex navigation flows. This video provides a step-by-step approach guiding you through setting up and using a coordinator so you can easily add sophisticated navigation to your iOS apps. Whether you're new to SwiftUI or experienced, this tutorial ensures you understand and can implement coordinators effectively. Navigation coordinator is part of the Black Friday sale. Go ahead and check out the link in the description for a 91% discount. So today we are going to talk about the navigation coordinator, how it's been set up, how to use it. And this is an ongoing series, like free tutorials will be made. Today we are going to just set it up. So first of all, make sure after your purchase, make sure that you check out the actual navigation coordinator for the demo. It has all the use cases. But today I am going to start off with a brand new Xcode project, and we are just going to build it out from scratch. So what you need to do is just go and add in the navigation coordinator resources. Here we go. All we have to do is just drag and drop it. Make sure that you copy files to destination and the target is also selected. Let's finish right over there. So next up, we need to set up our destinations. This is kind of a setup. You will understand when we are actually going to use the navigation coordinator. Let me just remove the canvas over here. We are going to create a new file. So let's create a new empty file, and let's call this a destination a plus. So we are going to do an extension on the destination file, which is part of the navigation coordinator. That's why we are having these errors currently. We need to adhere to the view protocol. So let's import SwiftUI, and then let's have an extension on the destination. And this extension will be on the view protocol. There we go. And now let's create. Yeah, of course, it's just complaining about the body, but after we do all the file, everything will be okay. So let's create those two destinations. We are going to have two views, one root view and the other one is where we are going to navigate. The first one will be the walk view and the second one will be the archery view. It's just what I call them in my example project, in the demo project. So what we need to do is just have a static let walk, and that is equals destination. That's how you would just create this enum. By the way, the destination is an enum, so we will be able to use it as an enum. Let's duplicate this and let's name this archery. There we go. And finally, we need to adhere to the view protocol, which means that we need a body right over here. A body, var body. There we go. So we are going to switch through the cases, like in this case, the walk and the archery, and we are going to give the actual views that we want to navigate to. Ready to level up your SwiftUI skills and build apps faster and smarter? My Black Friday bundle is here with a huge 91% discount. For only $199, originally $2,280, you'll get everything you need as an iOS developer, including SwiftUI Camp, the ultimate 4-week virtual bootcamp on Zoom. Starting December the 2nd, this immersive experience will transform you into an expert SwiftUI developer. Don't miss this chance to save big and sharpen your skills. The link is down in the description. So, switch, self, and we are going to have two cases, case dot walk, and yeah, walk view, archer view, this is fine. Currently, the walk view and the archery view is not created yet. We are going to do that in just a second. But for now, let's just add also the default of empty view, because we also need to set up a default because they are just static let cases. Okay, so walk view and archer view, let's just do them real quickly. New file from template. Let it be a SwiftUI view. Let's name this walk view. And then let's just add this hello walk view. And then the archery view. Let's just see it under the destination plus. Let me copy it out and right click again. New file from template, SwiftUI view. Let's paste it in there, archery view. Let's create it. And then again, let's just head there. Hello, Archer review. Now all of the errors should go away. Let's just wait for Xcode to see what we got over here. Okay, so let's hit Command B. So we are going to build. As you can see, build has succeeded. All the errors went away. We just needed this extension on the destination enum to adhere to the view protocol. So this is how you are setting up your destinations. How are you going to use it? Well, let's just go to the content view and let's just remove all of this stuff. And what you have to do is just set up your root view. We are going to also cover tab views. Stay tuned, subscribe to the channel. It will be the third to last tutorial. So now we're just going to have a simple route to our navigation. And that is being done with the navigation route. And we are going to select a destination for it. As you can see, conveniently, you can just choose from the ones that you have set up. So you just hit dot and select either of them. Let's just choose a walk. And that's it. Let's just build and run and see how this looks like currently. You know, just a few lines of code, and we already have the walk view as our navigation route. Here we go. It says, hello, walk view. Really nice. Now, let's just open up our walk view and let's just add basically a V stack and then just a simple button that we are just going to navigate to the Archer review. So let there be a button with the title of Archer review. And then the action. So we want to navigate to the Archer view. How do we do that? Well, first of all, we need to grab our environment of navigation. So Earth, environment, there we go. /dot. And there is this navigation. There's also tab navigation. We are going to talk about that when we are going to add in tabs. But for now, just simple navigation. Private var navigation. And you just grab it. Put it in there, navigation dot, and you will see some functions that you can use. What we are going to use is just push, and there is the destination type on dismiss, and maybe just on complete. Let's just use just a simple one with the destination. You can just, you know, take a look at the demo project, how to use on complete or on dismiss. This is really powerful when you are navigating backwards. So pushing, what do I want to push? Well, I want to push the Archer review. So let's build and run and let's see if this is actually working. And by the way, it will not. And why is that? Well, we need to add some extra stuff on the destination. Remember, we just added the walk view. We need to reference that. So what we are going to do is just add a dot and then destination. And the same goes for the Archer review, dot destination. Now let's go back to our button, as you can see. And that will actually connect everything together, and we will be able to navigate real quickly and easily. And, you know, just again, two lines of code, the navigation environment and just pushing it. Now, what if I want to present this as a sheet or a full screen cover? Well, there is this type where you can just choose from link that is set up by default, so you don't have to actually set it up when you are calling it. Let's just select sheet right over here. And if we tap on it, we are being presented the sheet. So changing between link style sheet or full screen cover style of navigation is really, really easy. Let's just have full screen cover right over here. Okay, so let's just wait for that, presenting the full screen cover, but we don't have a back button. Of course, we don't have a back button on the full screen cover. That's how it should be. And we also can't swipe down. So how do we pop? This is the final step that we are going to learn today in this tutorial. Let's go to our Archer review. I'm going to copy out the environment of navigation so I can just simply just paste it in there. Let's make that V stack again. So we have room for our button, and our button will be just simply pop. Okay, and the action, well, just go navigation dot and then pop. As you can see, there's also pop to, pop last, pop to root. It's, you know, we can just do a lot of popping. Again, a detailed explanation is in the demo project, but let's just see how it works. Again, two lines of code, accessing the environment of navigation and then just popping. Archer review and then popping it back. It's really, really amazing. By the way, this will also work. Let me just go back to the walk view and let's just set this back to link. I could just remove the type, of course, but now you will see that it's actually a link. Let's just go there, and popping also works. And it works together with the back button. So that is how easy it is to just set up simple and easy to use navigation coordinator with the help of my navigation coordinator. And remember, this is for a limited time part of the Black Friday sale. Go ahead and check out, the link is down in the description.